everyone! Today I'm guiding you through the basics of DNS records. Let's get started. What are DNS records? A DNS, domain name system, is a naming database where internet domain names are found and matched with their IP, internet protocol addresses. All computers, laptops, and your smartphone that connect to the internet find and communicate with one another by using numbers. But for us humans, it would be impossible to remember all those numbers every time we wanted to search for a website. Instead, we use domain names like example.com to find the website we're looking for. The domain name along with its corresponding IP address are referred to as a DNS record. Selected name servers are responsible for storing DNS data to keep everything working smoothly. When you visit a website repeatedly, it is cached by your computer's DNS cache. If it hasn't been visited and cached, a request is sent to your local DNS server. This video is actually, guys, brought to you by 10web, an AI-powered WordPress platform, which includes awesome products such as an automated website builder, hosting, and a page speed booster. Go, guys, and check this platform out at 10web.io after watching the video. And now, let's list the most common DNS record types. And number one is A, or address record. An A record is used to match a domain name to an IPv4 address in order to retrieve it. It makes the internet human-friendly by allowing you, as I already said, to enter the name of a website instead of remembering numbers. For example, an A record would allow you to use a website like www.yourdomain.com instead of typing in an IP address like 192.0.2.146. Number two, guys, is quad A record, which is a type of DNS record that points a domain or subdomain to an IPv6 address, so that when someone types that domain or subdomain in the address bar, the browser knows where to go. It has the exact same functionality as an A record, but in this case, IPv6 addresses are 4 times larger than IPv4 and contain 8 sets of numbers and letters. Here, a quad A record would allow you to use www.yourdomain.com instead of an IPv6 address like this one. And number three, guys, is CNAME record. CNAME records point domains or subdomains to another domain. For example, you need this record if you have a few subdomains such as mail.yourdomain.com and want them to point to your main domain name of yourdomain.com. This means when a DNS server hits the DNS records for mail.yourdomain.com, it actually triggers another DNS lookup to yourdomain.com, returning yourdomain.com's IP address via its A record. In this case, we would say that yourdomain.com is the canonical name or the true name of mail.yourdomain.com. Number four is NS record, or name servers. Name servers are the servers where all the DNS records are stored. In order to have a site live, you will need to have properly configured your name servers. Name servers are provided by domain name registrars or hosting providers. Now you can see an example of an NS record. So for domain.com, you will have an @. Record type will be NS, value will be ns1.domainserver.com, and for TTL, you will have 21,600. Number five, guys, is MX records, mail exchanger. MX records are used to point your domain to email servers using SMTP, simple mail transfer protocol. Like CNAME records, an MX record must always point to another domain. When an email server needs to deliver email to a recipient, it first needs to know where the recipient's mailbox is located. It does this by asking the DNS server for the server name of the server that has the mailbox. Email service providers give you a few servers in case that one or two of them should fail. These servers have a priority number set in front of them. They indicate the primary and backup mail servers. For example, emails sent to you.yourdomain.com would be sent to mail server mail.yourdomain.com with its specific IP address. Number six is TXT, or text record. Text records are used for various authentication methods. They are mainly used to verify the ownership of a domain and prevent spam by determining if the email was sent from a trusted source. You can have multiple TXT records. Now you can see an example of a TXT record, which will have an @ for example.com. The record type will be TXT, value will be information about the domain, and TTL is going to be 32,600. Number seven is, guys, PDR record, or pointer to a canonical name. A PDR record is a security tool. They are used to track an IP address to its domain or reverse DNS lookup. Essentially, when you receive an email, your mail server uses the PDR record that comes in with the email message to check that the mail server sending the email matches the IP address that it claims to be using. For example, guys, the PDR record for this IP address would be stored under this IP address with this at the end. Number 8 is, guys, SRV record, generalized service location. So SRV record specifies a host and port for specific services such as voiceovers, instant messages, and so on. It serves as virtual starting and ending points for different network traffic. An example of SRV would look like this one. Less commonly used DNS records include AFSDB record, CAA record, DNS key record, etc. We're not covering these ones, guys, today. We'll do it if you need them later. Until then, this was all for today. If you guys have any further questions about DNS records, leave them in the comments down below and our experts will address them. If you found this video helpful, give it a like, subscribe to our channel, and I'll see you next time.